Hey guys, it's Bonnie from BoulderBond. Welcome back. Happy New Year's to everyone. Now, New Year's is actually one of my favorite time of years because it's when I get to play around with all of my brand new planners, and I actually have quite a few this year. So if you guys are looking for inspiration for your own planner for 2019, this is definitely the video you guys want to check out. Not only do I have a ton of planners to go over and show you what I'll be using, but I also have one that I will be giving away to you guys, so definitely stay tuned and keep on watching. All right, so I'm gonna start with the oldies that are returning for 2019 and some of my absolute favorite planner systems. So the first one here is the Erin Condren desk pad calendar. Guys, this is super large. I can barely fit it in the frame. I adore this calendar. I have it sitting right at my desk, so every single morning I come out and do my daily to-do list down at the bottom here. I do have a video showing you my setup for this calendar, so I'll leave a little card in the right hand corner. I do separate each one of these columns, so it gives me a lot more space to write in and do separate to-do lists here. I'm definitely a list taker, so this is very handy. It's also so large that I use it as a mouse pad as well. It is super handy for that also, so that is definitely returning for 2019. Then of course my Erin Condren life planner will be returning. Now this is not a brand new Erin Condren. I did get a July 2018 to June 2019 planner, but I will be using this for at least the next 6 months. So I use my monthly spread to keep track of all of my YouTube video ideas. It's definitely been super helpful to keep me on track for that. I also use the note section here. Now this month is a little different because I used to do another note section on the right hand side, so I'm still playing around with how I want the note section to set up. This month I actually kept track of all of my like larger to-do tasks, so like calling my insurance company, getting my car registration, backing up my hard drive, things like that. A running to buy list I also added in there, goals for the month, events like birthdays and things like that. And then I usually like to write a little quote for the month to help me start out for the month. And then of course, if you guys don't see my plan with me videos, I also do plan with me videos on how I set up my weekly pages in here. Now this is more like journaling for me now because I do use the desk pad calendar to keep track of my to-do list, but I love having it in here as well because I throw away my desk pad calendar and I don't obviously throw away my planner. So I like to be able to look back and see everything that I did in that past week. There has been several times that I've gone to my old planners to see what happened for the month, what happened in that day, you know, when people get sick, when I get sick, all those things I think is super helpful to look back on. And I absolutely love decorating my planner and seeing all of these pretty stickers in my planner. So this is definitely returning for 2019. Now the last planner that is returning this year is my budget notebook. Now this is just an Erin Condren notebook that I use as my budgeting notebook. It says the secret to getting ahead is getting started. I absolutely love it. It's actually like a dot grid notebook with flags on the right hand side and left with a little asterisk there. And then there are some stickers in the back here, a folder that I actually put in. So it's one of those clip-in folders, and then a bunch of stickers that I need to put in here. I do have one spread that I can show you since it is not filled out. I do plan on doing an updated budget video for you guys so you guys can see how I set up my budget. So on the left hand side, I have the notebook calendar. It's two different stickers that I put down here. I like to write in all of the things like gas, my cell phone, all of those things on here when it is due. And then I transfer them to my budget so I can put in how much I spent for those items. Now, all of the Etsy expenses I don't put on here because that would just be chaotic. So I keep track of that on my phone and then I insert them here. Now I have these so you can set it up as all of this on the left hand side, the living expenses. You can get them with the living expenses or you can get them completely blank, or you can customize your budget sheets as well so that it will say whatever you like on there. Because like for me, these are Etsy expenses that I usually have every single month, so I don't want to write them for every single month. And then up here I have a total income, my Etsy, YouTube, tips, which I no longer have anymore since I quit my waitressing job, and then my CrateJoy, the gain and loss, and then the actual spent for everything. So that is how I have my budget notebook set up. So this is definitely going to be returning. Now I may change this in the future, but I do have tons of more space in here, so it may be around for at least another year. So that is a return. Now moving on to my brand new planners. This one is the Clever Fox planner. Look at how adorable they package their planner. So this is in a little white box that has the little fox on top here. They also have an insert here that has a picture of how to use this planner. So they give you several different ways. I absolutely love that. Have been meaning to do a vision board in my planner, and I love that they give you ideas on how to do that. Set your goals, choose five most important one-year goals and break them down. I love this. Monthly layout examples, and then a weekly layout example as well. I love that they include this. Very nice. Now this planner also comes with three icon sticker sheets. Very nice. And then look at how pretty this planner is. Now Clever Fox did contact me and asked me if they could send me a planner and give one away to you guys, and I was super thrilled that they contacted me, because I will tell you, I already had a Clever Fox in my cart to be purchased, so I was so excited that they reached out to me. Now this is going to be replacing my personal size planner for the year, so I will be taking this out on the go with me. My personal planner is what I use on the go, and I just think that this is going to be super helpful for that. They have lots of really fun pages in here. My gratitude, daily rituals, affirmations. This is the vision board. I think that that is so nice. A my goals section, a mind map, a focus of the five different goals there. And then all of the monthly spreads are up front here because it is an undated planner, which I think is very useful, especially since I do have a ton of planners. If I decide to skip this for the month, I can always come back and redo this for March. So I think that is super handy. That has the goals section down at the bottom there. Now for the weekly section, they have one page, four different lines horizontally, so all the way to Friday, and then they split up Saturday and Sunday. And then on the right hand side they have a goal section, a priorities for this week, a little note section here, a personal to-do list, a tracker here, which is really handy, this week's wins, and how I'll improve next week. And there are tons of pages, obviously, because it is set up for the year. And then in the back there are a ton of dot grid pages, so you can be very creative in this planner as well. Draw in here, use it halfway as a bullet journal to keep like maybe your collections in here. So like all of the books that you want to read, all of the things you want to try. I think that that would be really nice to have all of your collections in this planner as well. Oh, and it also has 3 silk bookmarks in here as well, and they are 3 different colors. So red, blue, and green. It also has a little pen holder here and a closure here as well. So I am super excited that they reached out to me. I cannot wait to start planning in this guy. I absolutely adore this cover. It is so cute with the little fox there and so nice and silky. And guys, this color is gorgeous. If you guys want to check out their planner, they have lots of other versions of this planner, plus a bullet journal. I'll leave their link down below. And if you guys want to win your very own Clever Fox, they have generously given this to me to give back to one of you guys. So stay tuned to the end of the video so you guys can see how you can win your very own Clever Fox planner in the same gorgeous rose color. So moving on to my next planner, I have another bullet journal for 2019. Now, last year was the first time I started bullet journaling, and I absolutely fell in love with it. I still love it so much, so I definitely wanted to make sure that that was in my lineup. Now, last year I used the Leuchtturm. This year I chose a Lemma May. I just wanted to see the difference between the two. If you guys want me to do like a comparison video, definitely let me know down below. I already did my 2019 setup, so I'll leave the link to that down below as well, along with my January setup as well. So I love, love, love bullet journaling. It's definitely becoming more and more of my favorite thing. Now, I have to say, I have been starting to scrapbook in my bullet journal, so it's definitely going to be not something that I can take on the go. That's why I think that the Clever Fox is going to be something that it will be nice to take with me out of the house, and then this thing will be sticking around in the house. Now, the last planner is going to be a happy planner. So I have not actually planned in a happy planner. I have had one in the past, but I didn't actually plan in it. I have had several people ask me to design weekly kits and monthly kits in the happy planner, and I figured if I'm going to start doing that, I want to actually start planning in it as well. I think it is a really fun planner, and I'm actually really starting to gravitate towards these discs, where in the past I actually did not care for them, but I really like it, especially in this planner. I just think that they look super cute in here. I love the idea that you can pull the pages out and add new pages. So I am already thinking about all the things I want to add in this planner. I am super excited to start making stickers for this planner as well. So if you guys have any suggestions for stickers, definitely let me know down below. I mean, obviously besides not like a weekly kit, since that's what I already plan. I love this section here too, where it has the birthdays, monthly goals, top events, and notes. I think it is super cute. Now, a lot of the happy planners are different depending on what cover you choose, it seems like, where sometimes it will be very colorful and festive on the inside here, and then others are more neutral. So you really do have to look and go in the stores to kind of feel out what style you like. It did seem like they had several different kinds, but I wasn't quite sure on all of the layouts. So I bought mine at Michael's instead of like looking on the website. So I absolutely adore the way this is set up, where it has cute little things in here already. So adorable. Let me go ahead and show you guys the end in case you guys are curious to see what else is in this planner. So I think that this is like the standard setup. So there really is not, no extras. There's only one extra note page at the back here. And then, like I said, these are removable. You can add a ton more notes in here. So I chose the planner that says, always take the scenic route, which is totally my style. If I'm driving, I want to go the scenic way. I don't need to get there the fast way. I want it to look pretty around me. And that is definitely my style of planning as well. So that is a look at all of the planners so far that I think I will be using for 2019. Now, because I do make my own stickers and I have my own Etsy store, there may be several other planners that I add to my collection. So I have the Happy Planner, the Clever Fox, the Lemma May for my bullet journal, my budgeting notebook, my Erin Condren life planner, and of course my desktop calendar. So I hope you guys enjoyed seeing my planner lineup for 2019. Now all of the links for all the planners will be listed down below if you guys want to check them out. If you want to win your own Clever Fox planner, all the rules will be listed down below. It will be super, super easy. Just subscribe to the channel. Maybe tell me down below what planner or planners you plan on using for 2019. I would love to hear. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks again for watching, everyone, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!